Mark, welcome to my home. This is part four of my move the water tank to the underside of my trailer video. If you haven't seen the other three, I'll leave a link here in the description so that you can watch those others if you haven't seen them. What I'm doing is in my 2015 Tab Maxis trailer, there's a water tank and in the kitchen. It's in the kitchen cabinet. These trailers are way too small to waste that kind of space. So I have already taken that tank out and cleared up that space so that my wife gets to use that cabinet for storage. We've prepped the trailer for a water tank underneath, and those tanks are coming. Well, today, some of the parts started showing up, and I wanted to talk to you about one of the upgrades that I'm going to do. I figured as long as I'm doing this work, I might as well make it better. I'm moving the water tank underneath the trailer to free up the space. I'm moving the water pump underneath the trailer for two reasons. One is that the water pump can be loud. I want it to be quieter. And moving it underneath the trailer will make it quieter because it won't be in the living space. And two, the space that's back behind the toilet in the bathroom, I want to make a big cabinet there to hold shampoos and soaps and all kinds of stuff. Basically what they call a shower caddy in that cabinet space where this pump was. So this is the pump that was out of my trailer. I want to talk to you about an upgrade that I'm going to do and some of the parts that started showing up. Well, we all know about these pumps. This is a motor, and it's got an offset wheel here, and that wheel pushes on pistons whoosh, like this. So the water that goes in here and comes out, it's doing that. From each time, you can see the four places where these four pistons are. Each time one of those hits, each one of those comes forward, you get a little pulse of water out here. So these guys are not loud necessarily because the pump is loud, but any of you plumbers out there that are experiencing, and just people who live in homes that understand what this process called water hammer is that air is compressible, but water is not. So that every time a pulse of water comes out here, it jerks the water in the pipes, and so the pipes move back and forth, and when it gets to a valve, it's hitting against the valve, and that's not good. Those pressure spikes cause noise, they cause rattling, they cause damage. So one of the things that came today was a Seaflow accumulator tank. And these are pretty neat. They're made for RVs. What this thing is, water comes in here and water comes out here, and inside here is a rubber diaphragm, and this is a Schrader valve, just like a bicycle tire pump valve. You recognize that. And what it does is that it hooks to the output of the pump. As a pulse of water comes into this line, instead of traveling all the way down and hitting the rest of your pipes, it acts as a shock absorber. This water, this diaphragm, moves up and down with the pulses. So what comes out of here is much smoother water. These accumulators, they do several things. Number one is they make your system a whole lot quieter. There's not that hammering going on, and the water that's coming in your faucet's not doing this business. It'll come out evenly. That's the first thing that it does. The second thing that it does is it makes work on your pump much easier. Now, Your pump will come up to pressure when you first turn your pump on, the zero water pressure, and the pressure will come up and up and up and up and up and up and up until it reaches its maximum pressure. And then there's a switch right here on the top of this guy that will shut the pump off. Well, as you use that water, the pressure comes down, 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 until it reaches what's called the turn-on point. And then it turns on, and it turns off, and it turns on, and it turns off. And it stays within this band. It doesn't go from full pressure down to zero before it comes back on. It goes from full pressure down to some other. Now, I've measured this pump, and this guy runs 33. It runs between 33 and 50 PSI. Now I know that it says, if you look up the specs on this particular model number, it says 40, but this guy's actually running at 50. So great, no big deal. So that what they want you to do is they want you to fill this pressure tank to be 3 pounds under the turn on pressure of this. So that water starts coming in here. Just as this pump turns on, this diaphragm starts moving up. So he acts as a shock absorber, makes things a lot quieter. But the other thing that it does is that this pump, if you think about the water doesn't compress. Air compresses, but water doesn't. So let's say that we don't have any air in our system. What happens is the pump comes on, and immediately when you turn a valve on, immediately, since there's no reservoir nor storage of any water, it drops down and it comes on and drops up. So this guy goes on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off, very, very quickly, on and off, because there's no storage of that water. Well, when you add this thing, what happens is this guy will, the pump will come up, and it will pump water in here. This is 0.7 liters. So it'll hold 0.7 liters of water until this gets pressurized. And then this will hold it. And if you turn my faucet on, the pump won't have to come on again until this accumulator is just about empty. So what this does is this accumulator smooths out this pump. The pump doesn't have to run it often. The pump comes on, it runs, it applies, gives you the water you need, and it fills this up. Then the pump turns off, and this guy supplies the water that you need for quite a while. Water will come out, and then this guy. So he will cycle on and off, rather than on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off. That's a whole lot better on the contacts here in the valve. It's a whole lot easier on the pump, and it actually draws less current, because you know that the most current is drawn in a motor when that motor is starting. So the less times we can make this motor start and stop, the less current it'll actually draw. So putting one of these on is really very simple. You basically take a double adapter like this, and you just screw it on, and then the pump screws on like that. And it's really nice. They're both made to do that. You can see that this guy's outlet is the same height, the same spacing. They're made to match up with these pumps. Well, another upgrade that we're going to do is when we mount this, I could, but I don't really want to. This pump can, they say that this pump should be mounted indoors. They don't want it outside, and so I've got to give this pump some protection. This guy doesn't need much protection, but this guy kind of does. They don't want, you know, salt and grit, and I don't want rocks hitting and stuff. So the second thing that came, this is an electrician's junction box. It's tough ABS plastic. It's that stuff that you can't break. Really strong. It has rubber knockouts. Or not knockouts, they're just rubber plugs so that you can put them in and out. So this is where normally in this electrical panel, this is where wires would come out. Well, for me, that's where water pipes are going to come out. And the neat thing here is that these two guys will fit exactly in there. The cover, like that. Cover's really nice. Got a rubber seal all the way around. Pretty much waterproof. And it will close. close up and seal just like that. And that's like a near perfect fit. So I'll have water coming in on one side and water coming out on the other. Really straightforward. This will give this pump and the accumulator some protection while it's underneath the trailer. But still waiting on the tank to show up and other parts, but they are starting to trickle in. Got my my drain valves here. So we're getting there, folks. Anyway, this was part four. Stay tuned for the next parts as the next parts of this video as they come in, and we'll get to the end of this project. But this is an upgrade that you should really be thinking about in your own trailers if you want to quiet your pumps down. And even if you don't take it out of, you know, where its mounting place is, if you just mount one of these right next to it and just, you can see how it connects in. It's really easy. Just mount this up here. This will quiet this pump down a lot and quiet your whole situation down. I highly recommend that kind of thing. And they're not expensive. So anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next one. Stay tuned. Drive safe.